Good morning, everybody.
And welcome back to another episode of Dude, What Are You Smoking? Well, I'm smoking the Second Wind from Fuerte Libre.
Ah.
So this is Fuerte Libre's newest cigar. It is not just a Dominican Puro, but it's actually the tobacco, 100% of the tobacco comes from the same plantation the Dominican Republic, which is
La Tabacalera.
Yeah, La Tabacalera. El Hoyito. Which I didn't means the hole.
So I didn't look it up. He looked it up.
I did.
So he could have spelled it wrong to me, and I'm pronouncing it wrong because of the way he spelled it. So I didn't
make
look.
Mistakes like that.
Yeah, but Brian never makes mistakes like that. I make more mistakes like that. So, yeah.
So this is the mildest of the Fuerte Libre cigars.
Mm. Yeah.
It does have a substantial amount of Dominican Piloto Cubano. It is a double Lajero cigar, so it is not mild, but it is medium minus, would say. Medium minus, mild plus, somewhere in that ballpark. Very tasty.
Medium,
you know,
negative.
Despite the fact that all of the tobacco comes from the same plantation, there is a depth of flavors that come through. There's a complexity that comes through because of the different, you know, the different primings that they've taken, the different aging systems that they've used. So you get a lot out of this cigar for it being a unique plantation cigar, 100% tobacco, manufactured, produced by one place. What are you smoking?
You didn't say it right. It's dude
what are you smoking?
All right. Well, I'm smoking the Sun Country from Fuerte Libre, which is a very unique cigar. It looks like it's going to be your mild cigar, Connecticut, but it is not. It is a full body, full flavored inside with an Ecuadorian Connecticut wrapper on the outside.
Medium plus.
So again, this is going to be an absolute medium plus, maybe even a full negative for those folks who smoke lighter than normal. Gorgeous flavor. Nice creaminess with that spice in the background. It is amazing. And they also came out with a different size, which is a Corona. And that Corona packs a punch. Even though it's smaller, it packs a bigger punch than this cigar here, to me.
Greg Free will be here, obviously, for this coming Thursday's Fuerte Libre event. 4 to 9.
Mm-hmm. 49.
49, you know,
it's
Greg.
It's Thursday, yeah.
Yeah, we mixed things up a little bit this month. Greg is a swag hag, I have to tell you. He sent us a lot of stuff for this event. He was very generous. So I highly encourage you to come out and try the Bodacious, the Bushwhacker, the Midnight Bender, the Sun Country, the Second Wind. Take advantage of his swag offers. Meet him himself. Ask him some questions.
Oh, yes.
I'm sure he's watching this video
I'm pretty sure he's going to watch it.
And he'll probably comment on the dude, what are you smoking segment.
So come on out on Thursday. I don't think we've discussed if we're going to have food or not on that Thursday.
I'm sure we'll have something.
But I'm sure we'll have something, just so you can say. We'll probably talk it over with Greg and ask him what he thinks that we should have.
And he'll probably say,
I don't know.
Discada.
Oh, discada. Again. So who knows? It might be discada.
We just had it for Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah, for Cinco de Mayo.
But,
so.
But it's a
twice in
it's
a
winner.
Month?
It's a winner.
Twice in a month? I don't know.
Right.
But anyway, I'm enjoying the cigar. It goes great with my coffee.
Yes,
I love the cigar.
Yeah. That Corona size in the Sun Country, surprising kick.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I think for a small cigar, it had a surprising level of potency to it. It was quite delicious.
It was very delicious. I quite enjoyed that.
We'll find out whether or not, maybe Greg will post it in the comments, whether or not Ed will be coming, his master taster.
Master taster.
But we look forward to seeing at least Greg and you on Thursday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go.
Reminder, there's two rows of parking in the back.
Yes.
Some of our events have been getting a little full. So if you come early, if you're a regular guy that's been here more than once, please, especially on event nights, try to park in the back, especially if you know you're going to be here late into the evening.
Yep.
And that way some of our newer, less experienced clientele find it a little easier to find somewhere parking. To park. And
yep.
Of course, there's plenty of space across the street with the volleyball complex.
Yep.
All right.
Cool. I think that'll do this segment of, dude,
what are you smoking?
I think we just started something.
You guys, stay safe.
Stay safe.
And stay healthy.
Salud. Salud.